Encouraging, empowering, inspiring each other on this journey of faith. United in purpose, sisters in love we are. Women were leaders.
Welcome to Empowering Lives with Purpose, and I am your host, Kimberly Hobbs. I'm the founder of Women World Leaders, and I am so thrilled to have back our guest today, Sandy Yozipovic. Welcome, Sandy.
Thank you, and it's an honor to be here, Kimberly. We just love the work that you and your team are doing, so thank you.
Amen, and we're just happy to have you part of that work. You've been in Voice of Truth magazine, and you're a Women World Leader as well as a Women World Changer. We are so grateful just to have this friendship and partnership to serve our Lord together. So she's done a podcast with us before in the past, and we're just so thrilled to have her back with us today. Ladies, we welcome you today, and this is for you. We want to encourage you. We want to empower you in our Lord Jesus Christ. And to do that, we love to share with other women their stories of what they are doing to serve the Lord in hopes that we can be encouraged from each other and just do more for the kingdom of God together. Ephesians 2:10 says that we are God's masterpiece. We are created anew in Christ Jesus to do the good things that he planned for us long ago. And ladies, we believe each and every one of you have a purpose, a good thing that God planned in your life long ago. And we're just hoping that we can help you to just dig a little bit and find out what that purpose might be and just get you passionate to use that purpose to serve our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And so as we get started today, ladies, we are going to talk about a topic that is pretty heavy. We're going to be talking about human trafficking. And I want to share a little bit about our guest, Sandy, today before we go into the trafficking. Sandy is a senior national sales director with her husband, Mark. They're business partners together, and they have pioneered the financial service industry across Canada for over 32 years already. They have over 40 regional presidents under them, and we are just so proud of them as a powerhouse couple in Primerica, which is the industry that they're in there. Sandy's a 19-year colon cancer survivor, and for the past 16 years, she served on the board of Invita Medical Center in Scottsdale, Arizona, and she also serves on the United States Freedom Alliance Board of Directors. She has overcome Guillain-Barré syndrome in her 20s, which had left her paralyzed as a quadriplegic. And we are so grateful that God healed her. This woman has been through so much, and she is so passionate about serving our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And human trafficking is just one of those things that she is so very passionate about. And she has served for 10 years in her charity organization of Women World Changers, where she's a founding member. And she's building safe homes across our world. And they are for the children that are rescued from human trafficking, sex trafficking. She's rescued hundreds of girls in this organization and has built over 26 safe homes already for these children. And their mission is to rescue and rehabilitate these children to become contributing members in our societies through God's love and grace. And Sandy's slogan is, "The journey continues and the healing begins." And I'm honored to have this woman and so many of her abilities to just be able to share with you today, just a glimpse of some of that. So ladies, human trafficking, there's a scripture verse that says, "Whoever steals a man and sells him, and anyone found in possession of him shall be put to death." That's Exodus 21:16. God is serious. He's serious about anyone who harms one of his children. And we should be that serious as well. When we respond to God's love, we begin to live with different values. And we start to take on that love that he has given to us so freely. We live the prayer, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. That's Matthew 6:10. So we also learn that the overflow of true loving God is to love our neighbors as well, right? We need to love our neighbors. And we care about the issue of human traffic and modern slavery because we believe that every single person, whether child or adult, male or female, is made in the image of God and therefore is valuable and worthy of dignity. And human trafficking, it dehumanizes people, turning them into objects and commodities. And it's very, very sad. And our hope is to see people restored into the fullness of who God created them to be. And Sandy, she's an advocate. And as we start off right now, I've asked Sandy to share just some of the horrors of human trafficking going on that maybe you're not aware of. And let's just bring that to the surface right now.
Well, you know, thank you. And I think awareness is probably the key word here, because 10 years ago, I didn't know. I mean, you hear about it. We've even seen, you know, movies depicted about it, but nobody really knew anyone that could put the emotion to it, or the physical part of it, to understand how much this is infiltrated into our society and even into our school system and even throughout our neighborhood. And it was 10 years ago that a group of friends, just, you know, women that, you know, women of God that just came together, and it was brought to our attention that this was an area where we could, you know, all raise money for and really help raise more awareness. All we wanted to do is just learn a little bit more, raise awareness, and maybe help, you know, a child or two. And the more we got into it, honestly, by the grace of God, is he was showing us, the light. He was putting a light specifically on the child trafficking. And I had no idea, none of us. And, you know, we're also busy in our day-to-day life as moms, as, you know, working, or, you know, trying to just deal with life. And then this kind of was presented in front of us. And God always has a purpose for why at that moment in time. And I will tell you, when that door was opened, we were all in. Because we knew that this was going to be a game changer in taking it from just being something that you hear about to something that people need to know about, and they need to take it seriously and learn about. And it started with the first guest that we had on to speak about this was a police officer who rescued a young girl who was 16 years old, or 14 years old, in school, and her boyfriend had groomed her. Now, she thought her boyfriend, who was in high school, you know, he had a driver's license, so she figured he was just a couple of years older. Well, he was literally in school outside of the school age, like he was over the age of 18. And we're talking that the perpetrators, the predators, can even be sitting at your Sunday night family dinner and everything's cool, getting to know everybody. Well, her particular story is he groomed her for at least a year, got to know everything about her in her life, everything. And before you know it, eventually drugged her and took her and threatened to kill her or her family. If she spoke, and he said, I know where you live. I know where your grandparents live. I mean, just the horror of if she didn't comply. And literally he would pimp her out up to five times or more a day to suffice, and just kept her nutritionally, you know, starving and drugged. And she lived that life for quite a while until this man saw her and asked her if she's in trouble, and she just started crying. And she was one of the success stories where we rescue, but it's the wounds that come after that now. It's the rehabilitation that, you know, this is not, that was not of God. God is in the rescue. The beauty is in the rescue and what can happen now with your life. And it's amazing. We became the first, you know, organization, Women World Changers, to actually help fund her radio show, and she became the most listened to, spokesperson for the awareness for child trafficking trade in the United States. And we buy like 30-minute sessions, I think once or twice a week, 30-minute airtime for her. And it just, all of a sudden, it just grew. And I can't tell you, her just educating parents on what to look for. You know, there's, I think I just read 900,000 predators are online. Wow. Are online. So you think about it, you know, our kids are on Instagram or Facebook or TikTok or whatever, you know, it was MySpace when I had my kids growing up. I had no idea that I had to worry about that on top of everything else. You know, the stranger danger that we teach our kids from a very young age, had no idea how powerful the internet had become to lure these kids into this type of a lifestyle. A lot of these kids are broken. They come from broken homes. Those are the most vulnerable. They just want to, you know, be somebody or have a purpose, and someone pays some attention to them. And it's so easy to be ensnared into that kind of a lifestyle. So we've seen the good, the bad, and the ugly. And we come alongside most of the kids that are the rescue. We did a lot of, I think, the early years, the first couple of years in the awareness. And then we started partnering with other programs like Saving Innocence in LA and the Deliver Fund in Texas, which actually has, you know, the latest in intelligence and technology, you know, artificial intelligence that can help, you know, go in and rescue these kids. And we're talking rescuing dozens of kids from a home and getting them back. And now we're partnering with even more so on the back end, developing new skills for them, helping them overcome, you know, through Christ, for the word of God, you know, to have, you know, introduce Christ back in their life, which there was no light. And now they have that light, because the average age of a child that is out of the sex trafficking trade is only 2.5 years once they're out, because of the drugs, the depression, you know, and suicide rates are so high. So we want to come alongside them and be that beacon of hope, you know, be that minister to their spiritual needs, because they've got to heal body, mind, and soul. I mean, it's the whole package. You can't just heal one part of that child because the wounds are so deep. So it is a journey and it's a commitment, but I tell you, it's probably, you know, the purpose that we found in this is to see that before and after shot, you know, is to see how they can transform their lives like this young lady did by now becoming a spokesperson for that. And there's many trafficked survivors that are now using their platform and their stories to inspire others to go and change their lives. So
when these women are taken, and they can be, you know, boys too. I mean, boys are taken into slavery as well. Is that correct?
Yes.
I mean,
yes.
Is there a ratio that are there more females than males, or?
I would say there's more girls than the boys, but the boys are a hot commodity. It's unbelievable. Some of the boys, you know, when you hear their stories, they're not the ones that they're not your typical online predator boys. It could be just their surroundings of who they're hanging with that they can be taken. You know, so I think the stat that I said, you know, 800,000 children go missing every year in the US, over 2 million globally. So these are anyone's kids. And, you know, what we found, which no, I didn't want to know, but we found out that a lot of parents who are struggling that have maybe addictions or whatever, they sell their children. They sell them to the traffickers. And you can't even imagine that is possible. That was probably one of the biggest eye openers, but they did what? They actually sold that child into that trafficking? Yes, because they could make up to $70,000 for a young child under the age of 3. So
that's right.
Who would have thought that there was money? But the money, the trade for it is over $1.5 billion a year. So it's bigger than the drug industry, drugs and guns. So this is the number one trade in the world, is child trafficking, human trafficking. And so
what are the ages, Sandy?
Well, one of the youngest that we had rescued was from the Dallas Super Bowl. I want to say it was like 5 or 6 years ago. And that was with our Deliver Fund group. And the youngest was a three-year-old little girl. And she would go for like $1,000, per session. And when we discovered that, because we got to hear about it after the fact, because we did like, it was like Operation Lipstick. And we were, we had special undercover people going up to the young girls on the street or the kids on the street. And in the lipstick, it had a little piece of paper in there or written on it, you know, if you need help, call this number. And a lot of rescues happened. And in fact, sporting events, especially the Super Bowl, is the number one event in the world for trafficking. More human trafficking or child sex slavery goes on those events than any other time.
Wow, this is so sad. It's so sad. And ladies, as the body of Christ, we're charged with a mission to offer new life and hope to those that are oppressed. It's our mission, ladies. Yes. It's not left for somebody else to do. This is what we are supposed to do. God says in his word, shout it aloud and do not hold back. Raise your voice like a trumpet. That's yes. Isaiah 58, verse 1. So don't ignore the oppressed, guys. Through scripture, God calls us to advocate and be those voices for those who are silenced or squelched through oppression, yes. Right? God says, arise, Lord, lift up your hand, O God. Don't forget the helpless. And there's a portion of scripture I wanted to read as well. But you, O God, see the trouble of the afflicted. You consider your grief and take it in your hand. You are a helper of the fatherless. Break the arm of the wicked man. Call the evildoer to account for his wickedness that would not otherwise be found out. That's Psalm 10, 12 to 8. God does care about the oppressed and the exploited, ladies, and we should too. And just as Sandy is out there and she is being that advocate and she's being that voice, we need to take time and pray for these people, the Sandys of the world that are out there doing something about it, and be this deliverance and have yes. victory in this human traffic area, right?
Yes.
Sandy, what are some ways that we can do this? Because it's unacceptable, ladies, to just go to church, to worship, right. and then, you know, do your religion and not do anything else about it. Honestly, we have to promote justice here.
Yes.
And do something. That's what we're called to do as Christians. What are some yeah. of the things that us as women could do to help someone like you that are in the trenches?
You know, we formed Women World Changers, and they can go online and get our email list, and you'll be able to hear some of the stories when we have our guest speakers that are on that are involved in the trafficking rescue of this and what they're doing for the programs and the projects that they're doing for the recovery. You know, I think the big thing is awareness. When I first started using my social media page for the child trafficking, human trafficking, it was like nobody, they didn't like, why is she doing that? Why isn't she posting pictures of her kids or at a family event? Because that's kind of what Facebook was for, right? And then all of a sudden I go, no, I have to do this. I'm being, you know, God is using me, using my platform and my voice. If I know this, I need to let others know it. And it just started with a couple of posts, whether it be articles on child trafficking or just a, you know, something you just post a stat. Do you know this is happening? Because, you know, every 2.5 hours, another child is taken and sold into, is kept. 100 to 150,000 children on any given day are in slavery. They're basically, they're enslaved. So those are the ones we've got to rescue right now, that we've got to reach, because you don't know if you're seeing something. You know, you're hearing that on flight attendants, even because the word has gotten out more, and especially during COVID, the child trafficking and the trauma for the child trafficking grew. It actually doubled. Because people were now locked in. And so people were literally selling their children for people to come to their home and abuse these kids. So, I mean, it just, the things I was reading, I'm like, Lord, this cannot be happening.
Uncomprehendable. It's uncomprehendable.
And you can see, they say that there is within every 2-block radius, there is, or I think it's a mile radius, that there is child people, somebody be using their home as a child trafficking hub. It is unbelievable. And I'm like, that can't be right. I heard that right. It is closer in our neighborhood than we thought. So, you know, there are great, causes or people that have already formed and they've done the groundwork. They've got everything all in place. Like Saving Innocence is one of the ones that we come alongside and we helped fund, not only in the rescues, but in the journey, when we take these children and we really rehabilitate them, we walk with them all through the rest of their life to help them develop life skills. We help them in the ministry. We help them get involved in ministry, whether it be through music, whether it be through teaching, whether it be just them learning. I mean, we're helping them with life skills. That is like the biggest thing. If we can get them feeling like they're valued again, they're invaluable, they're precious, they're God's children. So they've got all these gifts, you know, that may have been put aside because we've had to deal with all the ugly part of the healing. But now once that healing has begun and they learn how to trust again, these kids have been abused. They've been lied to. They've been betrayed. If we just show them love, which is the universal language in healing. And then we point them in the God's light, in God's way of thinking, and that not every human is out to hurt them or out to get them, that there are good people that can help them along this journey. And then we have Deliver Fund is the other, you know, the armed forces, the Delta Forces rescues team, that these are all retired, you know, veterans, military that are using their gifts. And we come alongside and now we're able to help not only rescue, but my gosh, you have them on your side and they've got your back along with God. These kids, I mean, it's these back programs, just be able to help them stand up again. Help them withstand the forces that tried to take them out or tried to take them down. We're going to build them up for the rest of their life so that they can be great contributors in society and carry the word of God to help the others that are wounded that haven't been rescued yet.
Yes, amen, Sandy. God calls us to identify with these. And some of these kids, they don't have families to go back to. They're orphans and they have been taken, sold into sexual slavery. They don't know who their parents are. They've been there for years and years and years. So we need to be compassionate. I have another scripture. Continue to remember those in prison as if you were together with them in prison. Mm-hmm. And those who are mistreated as if you yourself were suffering, Hebrews 13:3. So again, God calls us to identify with and suffer alongside of those who are in bondage. We have to show active compassion, ladies. Yes. And so Sandy is giving us ways and abilities to do this and not to turn our backs and just show a deaf ear because we don't know what to do. We cannot claim that we have ignorance in this area. And that's one of the reasons that I felt compelled to bring Sandy on today is just, again, she's passionate and she sees the need for these kids once they're rescued, what to do with them. We need more feet on the ground that are going to say, yes, here I am. I will be used. I will help rehabilitate these children. I will show them the love of Jesus.
It could be as simple as, you know, we need the prayer warriors, especially to, you know, to pray for our special forces that are in there. Cause you know what they have to see, they're seeing the lowest of low and, you know, they're seeing the demonic side of these things. And so we need a lot of prayer for our rescuers. But boy, the best way that anybody can help, you know, log on to womenworldchangers.org. It's womenworldchangers.org. You know, be a part of our email list. Subscribe to get our email. We only send them out like every month or so. You'll get a notice when our next Women World Changers call. We do them about every quarter. And we have these guests on. We have these examples. And, you know, not only do we need your prayer, but we need you helping to bring awareness to everybody. So it might be posting something that you see on our website or something that you heard on that day and create that awareness. So other parents are aware that there's this onslaught of predators that are out there ready to take, you know, to pounce on our kids at any time. The awareness, but I'm telling you, it's the donations. And it could be a donation of $10. It could be a donation of, you know, $50, $100. Anything helps to support the programs to allow these kids the skills that they need to get to be able to assimilate back into society again and become a productive member. We don't want to have these kids come in, be rehabilitated, and go back, get drawn back in or sucked into, you know, the drugs or whatever, because they can't cope. This is a ministry that keeps on giving. So we're all called to be disciples. We're all called in our own purpose, in our own time, to be able to disciple to those that are less fortunate, or those that are wounded, and I'm telling you, these kids need our help. That is probably the best way, is a donation to help these brave people, these people who've given up their lives to give back to these kids. And they're doing amazing, amazing, amazing things with these beautiful, beautiful souls.
Amen. Amen. And Sandy, you are, again, hands-on working with these organizations that go right in,
yes,
and rescue these kids out. You see the bad and the ugly. Mm-hmm. You see, yeah, it all. And it's heartbreaking. And so, ladies, again, we need the help. This is a call to action. We need more prayer warriors. We need more givers. We need more that will sacrifice time and reach out and say, you know, I have two hands. I have two feet. I can do something. So thank you for sharing your website, Sandy, that women can go to and plug in. So in closing, and again, this just time goes by so quickly, but what can you leave the woman with that is listening? Because we have women listening around the world. We're in 60 different countries, Sandy. This is happening globally around our, yes, world. What can you charge them with right now that, you know, God is just putting on your heart to just leave them that lasting impression to get busy and do something?
Well, I think it's biblical when you can say, if I can do it, anyone can do it. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I was called, I had the tug, you know, on my heart 10 years ago, had no idea, you know, where it was going to take us now. But I really believe if we can all, you know, just play some part and be able to stand in the gap for these kids that can't right now. And so I really want to, you know, I feel like I'm called to be that trumpet. It's funny that you use that scripture, because that's how I feel, that I need to be that voice to get people's attention. But can you imagine if this Facebook Live, if we just had 100 people, even just 100 people that see this for the first time, you know what? I need to know more about this, or I need to tell so-and-so about this. Did you know this? That's how it all starts going. Before you know it, our efforts of standing the gap are multiplied into the thousands and into the millions worldwide. So it really is a calling that we need more Esthers of the world. We need more people, you know, to just stand in that gap and be there and, you know, be bold. Be bold in confronting evil, because that's what this is. And that's this, right, is where we're all called at this moment in time, because there's forces in this world that we all know that we have been given the authority. We have been given everything we need to claim, right, victory over all of this evil. Every child is a child of God. And if we can do our part, might be the littlest thing, but we just do something to do our part to save another child's life, we become different makes. So you become a world woman leader and a woman world changer, all in one, all in one. It's all good.
And that's what you are, Sandy. You are a woman world leader. You are a woman world changer. We are so grateful for you. And ladies, honestly, this is who we are. We are here as women changers for this world. You know, we are here to make a difference. We are to lead other women into making a difference. How are we going to do that just sitting on our butts and not doing anything and listening to everybody else who's doing it?
Right.
No, we have to call to action all the women that we can to bring them together for this purpose and to do something about it. So here we are, we're giving you this information, hopefully that you will listen in, and God will stir in your heart to get motivated to do something in this area. And don't think that you don't matter. You matter. Yes. Your prayers matter. your dollar matters. Yes. You don't have to give $100,000, give a dollar, you know? And if everybody felt that way, and we had all of these thousands of people listening, look at the difference that our giving is going to make. And then, of course, that action. So we just can't say it enough. You know, we are passionate. We need more help. We need more women that will say, yes, Lord, here I am. Send me. So will you be that woman? And again, we are grateful that you are here, that you tuned in for this half an hour segment. And ladies, we want to tell you at Women World Leaders, we do have tools for you personally. Maybe you were one that was rescued out of human trafficking, and we praise God with you, and you are hurt, you're broken, and you just need that encouragement. Well, that's what we do here at Women World Leaders. We're here to encourage you, strengthen you, and empower you to walk in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and be a difference in this world. We have many tools for you. We have books that you can get. You can go on our website, womenworldleaders.com. We have the monthly, bi-monthly magazine, Voice of Truth, that comes out. And this is filled. Sandy has written many in Voice of Truth already, and we are grateful for her. But there are nuggets in here. There's scriptures in here. This magazine is filled with, again, encouragement for the woman every single day, and it'll be enough content for 2 months of time of reading. So readies, you can sign up if for outside of the country digitally by leaving us your email at info@womenworldleaders.com, or you can read it digitally on our website at womenworldleaders.com. If you live within the United States, you can get your free beautiful color copy by going again to info@womenworldleaders.com and leave us your name and your address, and still leave us your email address. Ladies, again, this has been a pleasure to just come to you quickly for this half an hour, which goes by so fast, but we need to close for right now. So from his heart to yours, ladies, we are Women World Leaders and Women World Changers.
That's it.
And thank you, Sandy, for being our guest today.
Thank you. It was an honor.
Amen. Amen. You're a beautiful soul. And we just, whenever we can get a little bit of Sandy Yozipovic, we are going to have you on, girl, because you have so much to share. And we haven't even touched the tip of the iceberg with what this woman does. Oh my goodness. She has her hand in so many amazing things for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We need a million Sandy Yozipovic. So thank you, honey. Thank you. Thank you. So ladies, all content is copyrighted by Women World Leaders and cannot be used without express written consent. God bless you all. Tune into our podcast each Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. We would be happy to have you join us. God bless you and have a beautiful day.